First from the book of Isaiah, followed by Mark's Gospel.
First reading, Isaiah 25, 6 to 9. Isaiah 25, 6 to 9. On this mountain, the Lord Almighty will prepare a feast of rich food for all people, a banquet of aged wine and the best of meats and the finest of wines. On this mountain, he will destroy the shroud that enfolds all people, the sheet that covers all nations. He will swallow up death forever. The sovereign Lord will wipe away the tears from all faces. He will remove his people's disgrace from all the earth. The Lord has spoken. In that day, they will say, surely this is our God. We trusted in him and he saved us. This is the Lord. We trusted in him. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is salvation. The word of the Lord.
The second reading for today is from Mark chapter 16, verses 1 to 8. The Gospel of Mark chapter 16, verses 1 to 8. When the Sabbath was passed, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb, and they were saying to one another, who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance of the tomb? And looking up, they saw that the stone had been rolled back. It was very large. And entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, dressed in a white robe, and they were alarmed. And he said to them, do not be alarmed. You see Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you. And they went out and fled from the tomb, for trembling and astonishment had seized them, and they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. The word of the Lord.
Greetings and a warm welcome to all of you in the most blessed name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. The theme that I have chosen is based on Mark's Gospel, where the angel of the Lord is telling these women who have gone to anoint Jesus Christ with the spices. The burial of Jesus Christ was in very hurriedly done because the Sabbath is about to begin. The sunset is the beginning of the day. The sunset is the beginning of the Sabbath on Friday evening. So that is the reason before the Sabbath begins, they want to bring down Jesus from the cross and wrap him and put him in the graveyard. And because they were unable to honor the body of Jesus, or they were unable to do proper burial, the women have taken the initiative to go early in the morning and apply all these spices to the body of Jesus Christ. If you look into Matthew Gospel chapter 28, verse 1, there we see that these women were going early in the morning, on what business? To anoint the body of Jesus Christ. That means they love Jesus so much. They demonstrating the love towards Jesus Christ. Adivaramuna pendalakadane ani raayabadunnadi. That means the Sunday is the beginning of the week, the first day of the week for the Hebrew people. And here we see that Matthew Gospel writer is reminding to the readers that women, and he gives some names over there, and there were other women too. And they were going early in the morning for what? To go and anoint and honor the body of Jesus Christ. Likewise, Mark Gospel writer also reminds the same thing in Mark chapter 16, verse 2. There also, again, Mark Gospel writer is telling the same thing, that women have gone early in the morning. And when you look into Luke's Gospel chapter 24, verse 1, there also you see the emphasis is that early in the morning, the priority in the beginning of the week is to go and honor the body of Jesus Christ for these women. And also likewise, John's Gospel writer also mentions the same thing. John's Gospel, chapter 20, verse 1. If you read these four Gospels, some of the parables are told in some Gospels and other Gospels have not recorded that. And likewise, we see some of the stories which they want to narrate about Jesus Christ. Some Gospel writers recorded, the other Gospel writers did not. Whereas the resurrection narrative we see in all the four Gospel writers. They are presenting the power of resurrection. Because if one person says, people may not believe. If two persons say also, people may not believe. That is the reason four people have recorded this resurrection event. Four people are telling repeatedly the same thing. Who have gone the first day of the week early in the morning is women. I really congratulate and admire all the women that God has given you this privilege. God has given you that heart. God has given you that burden to honor Him, to give Him and make Him as a priority. Even in Proverbs chapter 30, we see a wise woman will be like this. If you have time, you can read Proverbs chapter 30, where it is recorded about how the quality of a wise woman, qualities of a godly woman, qualities of a God-fearing woman. If the woman of the house is really God-fearing, wise, and prayerful, definitely everything will fall in place. Women play a very vital role. It is not to undermine the power of women. And that is the reason, though the Jewish cultures do not give importance to women or a women witness in the Mosaic law, but still here Gospel writers are presenting this event saying that women were the one who gave priority to experience Jesus's body and to honor Jesus's body. Today it is a powerful reminder that to honor the Lord, the priority in our life should be early in the morning. Early in the morning. It is not weekends. It is the beginning of the week. It is not the weekends that when we get time, we want to go and honor the Lord. No, beginning of the week, beginning of the day. We need to honor God. We need to make a priority. Mana jeevithallo prabhunu prabhuku manamu pradhanyata ichchu. ప్రప్రదంగా మన జీవితంలను ఆరంభించాలి. మన దినచర్యను ఆరంభించక మునుపు దేవుని సన్నిధానంలో గడిపి మన జీవితమును ప్రారంభించాలి. దట్ ఈస్ ది ఇంపార్టెన్స్ దట్ వీ సీ హియర్ ఇన్ దీస్ ఫోర్ గాస్పుల్ లెసన్స్ దట్ ఈస్ రికార్డెడ్ అబౌట్ ది రిజరక్షన్ ఈవెంట్స్. అండ్ బిఫోర్ గోయింగ్ దేర్ విమెన్ వేర్ హ్యావింగ్ సో మెనీ క్వశ్చన్స్. దే వర్ సేయింగ్ that big stone, who is going to roll away for us? The big stone, who is going to roll away for us? And further, we see that they were fearing that, you know, somebody might have done something to Jesus's body. They were so worried. They were so conscious about the things that are going to happen. They were unable to realize that he is going to be risen. Likewise, even disciples also. Fearing the Jews, fearing the authorities, they have locked their doors and they were sitting inside the doors. They were fearing. When Jesus Christ is risen, the angel of the Lord is telling, come and see, he is not here. He is risen. He is not here. He is the God of the living. He defeated the death. That is the news that angel of the Lord is proclaiming. The angel of the Lord is reminding that, you know, the resurrection has occurred. In Matthew Gospel writer, we see in Matthew chapter 28 that there was an earthquake too. There was an earthquake. There was an unusual thing which has happened in the human history. People died and they never come back to life. Only prophets go to a dead child and they raise that child back to life. Lazarus, friend of Jesus, died and Jesus goes there and he calls him out of the tomb. And no one called Jesus out of the tomb. This is another fulfillment of the promise or the assurance that what Jesus Christ has told. I have authority to lay down my life and take it back. Jesus has the authority over life. Jesus is authority over life. Jesus is having this tremendous power because he is the beginning and he is the end. He is the Alpha and Omega. He is the Lord from the beginning to the end of our lives. No more deviations, no more diversions. We need to be under the sovereign authority of Jesus because he is the controller of our life. He is the authority of our life. Therefore, we need to learn to honor him, looking at this and remembering the events which have happened 2,000 years ago. I would like to remind two important things. We can talk so much about resurrection and events. And in the following weeks, we are going to focus what was happening for the next 40 days with Jesus after his resurrection. How Jesus had to again reaffirm and remind people that he has come back to life, that he defeated death. And today we are going to focus on two things. Resurrection is assurance. Resurrection means it is an assurance to all of us. And secondly, resurrection is commissioning. Resurrection means commissioning. If you look at the first thing, resurrection is assurance. Much before the news of resurrection has come, all the people who were following Jesus Christ were in a deep sorrow. They were crying. They were weeping. They were unable to accept the fact that Jesus is no more with them. So many memories are fresh with them because Jesus was with them for the last three and a half years, engaging them in so many kingdom works, teaching them, reminding them what it means to follow Jesus. And if that same person is not there, if the same person is accused and crucified on the cross, they felt powerless. They felt powerless. When do we cry? Do we really cry or make others to cry? Some people are specialists in that, isn't it? They never cry. They make others cry. That is a beauty. And some people, for no reason, they cry. Tears will be ready. And for some people, if anything they see, any emotional thing, even if it is not related to them, they cry, whether it is men or women. If they feel some sad story, they cry. If they witness a sad event, they cry. Likewise, so many people might have cried and wept when Jesus is crucified. To Mary, his mother, and to his disciples, and many other close followers of Jesus Christ, this was a shocking separation. They were unable to accept it. A young man of 33 years is being crucified on the cross. A young man, an innocent man, a young man who never committed any sin, a young man who led a righteous life, a young man who was always doing good. When such a kind of person dies, we all weep, we all cry, we all show our sympathy. And likewise, many people may be crying, listening to the news of Jesus Christ. And there we see that Mary Magdalene, she goes and she was searching Jesus' body. She was going and weeping. She was going around and asking the angels, asking Jesus also, assuming that it is gardener. She was going around and inquiring about the body of Jesus Christ. But when we are in sorrow, when we shed our tears, when we are in deep despair, when we feel helplessness, it is the risen Lord who appears to us. Jesus Christ appeared to Mary. Mary, immediately she was able to recognize Jesus Christ. Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, when we are in hopeless situation, when we are in helpless situation, when we cry, we have a God who answers and sees our cry. He answers our prayer. He responds to us. When Lord Yahweh came down to speak to Moses and commission Moses, what did the Lord God tell Moses? I have seen the cry of my people. I have seen the cry of my people. We serve a God who listens to our cry, our moaning, our helplessness. In the helpless situation, when we look to Lord, we cry, we shed tears. And those tears will not go in vain. When we supplicate to God, shedding our tears, those prayers will not go in vain. That is the assurance that we have through the power of resurrection. What a blessed assurance it is. Jesus Christ is coming and taking away all the fear, all the sorrow. The women who were there, they were confused when they heard that Jesus' body is not there. They were assuming that somebody stole the body of Jesus Christ. They did not see, they did not listen from anybody. They assumed. Assumptions are very dangerous. We always assume, isn't it? Nenu anukunnanu ila. అనుకోకుండా ఇలా జరిగింది నేను అనుకున్నాను నువ్వు అనుకోవడం కాదు అక్కడ ప్రభువు నీకు చెప్పాడా నీవు అక్కడ చూసావా మరియు అనుకుంది ఏమనుకుంది ఎవరో ఎత్తుకెళ్ళిపోయారని ఆ అనుకోవడంతో పొరపాటు ఏమైందంటే యూదులకు కూడా ఒక ఇన్సైట్ ఇచ్చినట్టు అయింది అక్కడ ఈవెన్ ద అథారిటీస్ వర్ కాలింగ్ ద గాడ్స్ అండ్ టెలింగ్ దెమ్ సే దట్ జీసస్ డిసైపుల్స్ ఆర్ స్టోల్ ద బాడీ కొన్నిసార్లు మనం అనుకుంటే అది చాలా డేంజర్ వి అజ్యూమ్ విచ్ ఈస్ ఆల్వేస్ డేంజరస్ అండ్ వి డోంట్ యాక్సెప్ట్ ద ఫ్యాక్ట్స్ ఆల్సో బికాస్ ఆల్రెడీ వీ హ్యావ్ మేడ్ వన్ కన్సెప్షన్ ఆల్రెడీ వీ హ్యావ్ క్రియేటెడ్ వన్ అజంప్షన్ అండ్ వీఆర్ నాట్ ప్రిపేర్డ్ టు యాక్సెప్ట్ ద రియాలిటీ బికాస్ అవర్ ఈగో విల్ నాట్ పర్మిట్ వాట్ ఎవర్ వీ సే పీపుల్ షుడ్ యాక్సెప్ట్ ఇట్ ఇజ్ంట్ ఇట్ సో వీ ట్రై టు బిల్డ్ ఆన్ స్టోరీ ఆన్ దాట్ Mary also felt the same thing. She felt somebody stole the body of Jesus. And she even asking Jesus Christ, assuming that he is the gardener. Jesus himself is appearing and she is unable to recognize. She went to seek Jesus. She went to anoint Jesus. But when Jesus is appearing, she was unable to recognize Jesus. This is one of the problems with the believers' community. We want to follow Jesus, we want to be with Jesus, sometimes we are not able to recognize Jesus. We are unable to recognize Jesus. We are unable to demonstrate to the people that we are with Jesus. We are always with some kind of preconceived notion that somebody has taken away Jesus. Somebody took away Jesus, somebody is hiding Jesus, somebody is confining Jesus. He cannot be confined. He cannot be controlled. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, when we lead a hopeless life, God is giving us this blessed hope. It's a powerful reminder. When we cry out of helplessness, He is stretching out His hand and giving us that assurance. Do not worry. In our life journey, there are so many occasions that we cried, isn't it? For our life, for our family, for our situation. When people insult us, when people reject us, when people put us down, when people ignore us, we experience in our day-to-day life, whether it may be in India or in the United States, helplessness is not an exemption. It is part of our life. But when we look to God, when we recognize Him, definitely, He is going to take care of those things. What did the disciples do? For three and a half years they have been with Jesus. What happened? Fearing the Jews, fearing the authorities. They were in upper room, not even on the lower floor, upper room. In Arizona, we also feel more comfortable, isn't it, staying upstairs. Whether upstairs or downstairs. If the scorpion has to come, it will come. Our assumption, if we are upstairs, we are safe. Disciples also same mentality. They were in upper room, assuming that nobody will come. Nobody can harm them. What did they do? They locked the doors from inside. They locked the doors. In America, doors are not that really powerful. But in India, we used to have powerful doors, isn't it? No one can really break in. We can close very tightly, airtight. Here, doors are not doors. Walls are not real walls. I'm talking about the real walls in the Asian context. Real doors in Asian context. And disciples were so much so conscious that no one should touch them. No one should come and ask them about Jesus. Peter already cleared to people saying that I am not an associate of Jesus Christ. And one man, when Jesus was arrested, he tore his clothes and ran away from there. And all the disciples ran away. They thought the mission has come to an end. The mission has come to an end. This is another assumption, a dangerous assumption. If Master is not there, how? If the Master is not there, what shall we do? They may be fearing and also may be scheming what to do next. Now all these years we have been so proud that we are with a young man. We thought he is going to live long. We expected that he is going to do more miracles, mighty things. And if we are with him, we are going to have some identity in the community, some power in the community, recognition in the community. Now all those expectations got shattered. Sometimes we follow Jesus for those reasons. We feel that, you know, we'll have some identity. For identity's sake, we use the ministry as a platform. That is a dangerous assumption again. If the platform is not available, then we'll withdraw. We don't follow Jesus. If you are following Jesus only for miraculous signs, that is another dangerous assumption. For some kind of identity, it is also a dangerous assumption. Come out of these fears. Jesus Christ. Again, he is taking the initiative. It is not the disciples who have taken initiative, or they are not praying at least. Lord, we miss you. Lord, instead of you, we should have been crucified. They didn't say that. They were not praying. When Jesus was with them, Peter dared to say that, Lord, even if death has to come, it should pass me. Enta goppa assurance. Prabhu, marnam ante nannu daati povala. Oka goppa veerudu annadu Petru akkada. Entante marname antu vaste nannu daati ellala. Anta goppa assurance ichinatuvanti Petru emayipoyadu. These all representations of human weaknesses. You know, sometimes we also say, I am ready to die as a martyr for Christ. If the real situation comes, we won't be there. During our baptism, during our conversion, we'll say, yes, I am ready to die for Christ. With Christ, I am going to die. If real situation demands you, are you really prepared to give your life? Little inconvenience comes, we give up on God, isn't it? Sometimes God's ministry, God's work, God is not a priority when we compare to our day-to-day life journeys. We'll postpone, later on I can do. Jesus can understand this. And we'll pray also, Lord, anyhow, you only gave me this, no? We are very clever. We try to advocate and convince Jesus in our prayers. Lord, you know how busy I am. I don't have time, Lord. When you give me the time, I'll give you. But I don't want to create. That is our weakness. We are so weak. Whatever promises we make with God, we forget. Whatever pledges we make, we do not keep up those things. Whatever promises we make to God in our prayers, we don't keep up sometimes. We'll try to postpone. The disciples, they also might have felt that everything has come to an end. They were fearing and they closed the doors and they were inside. But again, look at the initiation from Jesus. It is Jesus who has taken initiation. It is not the disciples who are going around the graveyard. It is not the disciples who are praying, Lord, come back. They were not doing that. Sometimes when things are out of our hand, sometimes if you are unable to do, we are very clever in saying, probably this may not be God's will. We try to do that way, but disciples, they were not able, they did not learn this idea at that time. When things go possible, favorable, we'll say, God has really favored me, brother. God has blessed me so much. When things go out of hand, immediately we say, this may not be God's will. This is not God's will. You need to keep on praying. You need to keep on waiting on Lord. You need to wait for the Lord. You and I are so important to God that He is coming after us. When Adam and Eve have sinned and disobeyed God, they did not go to God and confess. It is God who comes and asks them, Adam, where are you? I want to have conversation with you. I want to have fellowship with you. Come. What was the response? Lord, I am naked and I am hiding. And here Jesus' disciples were again hiding. Again, God is coming. Jesus is coming and appearing to them. What was the blessing that Jesus Christ is giving? Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Overcome every fear. When you are in Lord, when you are with God, there is no room for timidity. No room for coward people. In Book of Revelations, it clearly mentions, in the kingdom of God, there is no room for several worldly character people. He mentions there. One among those is coward people. Pirki variki devuni rajyamlo sthanamu ledu. The timid people do not have room or place in the kingdom of God. That is the reason Jesus is delivering his disciples. Overcome every fear. Come and experience me. Come and experience me. That was the invitation Jesus Christ gave. When Jesus appeared, they were unable to realize and recognize Jesus. They thought it is the ghost of Jesus. Our grandparents, some of them have passed away. If they come back to life and appear to us, what would be our reaction? If they appear in your dream itself, you'll be so troubled. Why my grandfather has come to my dream? Is his soul going around me? Did I not keep up my promises, what I gave him? Some women, husband and wife conversation. They'll have this kind of conversation saying that, you know, if I die, what are you going to do? Then dayamayochi ninne vartha. They are sure they are going to become evil spirit. They are not sure that they are going to be with God. What kind of faith do we have? Then dayamayochi ninne vartha. Definitely nu dayanvi annattu nirdharam chesukunnatte. Ninnu odili ponu, nu ekkadiki pothavo ninnu chustha untanu. నన్నే తలంచుకుంటూ ఉండాలి. This is how we make conversations, isn't it? Jesus' disciples' heart also might have stopped for a second. Oh my God, Jesus' spirit is coming here. It is a ghost. They are not even daring to go and touch Jesus Christ, talk to Jesus Christ. When Jesus Christ revealed his wounds, then they believed. Then they realized, yes, it is our Lord Jesus who has come back to life. It is our Lord Jesus Christ who has redeemed us from this fear. When we are with Jesus, our doubts are cleared. When we are in Jesus, our fear is taken away. When we are in Jesus, we would be filled with the courage. No more fearing the world. No more fearing the evil. No more fearing anything in the world. Fear is something created externally and imposed or influenced on a human body and mind. Fear and pain is not something which comes to a human being by birth. They are externally acquired. Fear is something that we teach for our children. Pain is something that we teach. These are the two external things which come from the world. And Jesus Christ is trying to eliminate these fears. Eliminate the pain. Eliminate the pain in death. He has taken away the pain of dying. He has given us that blessed hope and assurance that even in death, He is with us. Even after death, we are going to be with Him and He is going to be with us. That is the promise that we need to claim in our life. Yes, if I die, I'm going to be with Jesus. How many of you are really confident about that? Yes, if I die, if I have to leave this world, I am going to be with Jesus. I am not going to be an evil spirit and torment my own family. Nenu chanipothe Yesu tone untanu. Nenu chanipothe Prabhu tho untanu. Dayamai vachi intolanu peedinchanu. I am going to be with Christ. That is our faith. Because He is the living God who defeated death. The hope that He has revealed to us, He has demonstrated to us. In these both incidents, one thing is common, that Jesus Christ is coming in the hopeless and in the fear or frightened situation. For Mary, who was crying, Jesus appeared. The disciples who have withdrawn and were hiding, fearing people, there Jesus Christ is appearing. If you are going through any kind of fear, if you are going through any kind of sorrow, if you are worried about your future, if you are worried about your status, if you are worried about your life, if you are worried about your children, kneel down. Shed your tears in the presence of God. He is going to wipe away every tear. He is going to make you courageous and He is going to bless you to be His representative. The second thing that which I would like to focus in our meditation is resurrection means commissioning. Resurrection means commissioning. First thing is assurance. After receiving the assurance, after experiencing the assurance, the second thing is commissioning. When the angel was inviting these women in Mark Gospel chapter 16, we read, here we see that the angel of the Lord is telling the women, go and tell the brothers. Go and tell the brothers. Now you have seen, He is no more here. He is risen. Now your duty is to go and tell your brothers. Whether they believe or not is not your part. Telling, communicating is your part. Many times we have an assumption that if no one is listening, no one is believing, why I should tell? Telling is our part. Whether people listen or not, because God is going to knock their hearts. Sowing the seeds like a farmer, the Jesus Christ gave a beautiful, powerful parable. A sower was carrying the grain and was going towards the field. Some fell down among the thorns and bushes. Some fell on the ground. Some fell on the rock area. And some fell on the fertile ground. Likewise, communicating gospel is our role and responsibility. The angel of the Lord was telling, now go and tell brothers that he has been raised. He is not here. Go and tell. And we see that when this woman goes and tells, in John's gospel, we see that disciples were running towards the tomb. Peter, James, John, and others. They were running towards the tomb. But here the angel of the Lord is saying, ask your brothers to go to Galilee. There is going to meet them. Mary also, when she recognized Jesus, Jesus was telling, go and tell my brothers, I'm going to see them in Galilee. The ministry where Jesus began, a Gentilic land, a land where people do not know what is light, a land where people do not know what it means to follow a living God. There Jesus Christ has laid foundations to begin his ministry across the Sea of Galilee. And again, Jesus, after his resurrection, is going there. He is not just the Lord of the one chosen community. He is the Lord of nations. He is going to the nations, a cosmopolitan city of the time. And Jesus is going there and is asking his disciples to go and wait there. Jesus is asking his disciples to wait there. Jesus is asking Mary to go and tell the brothers. The angel of the Lord was telling. In Matthew chapter 28, we see that Jesus said to them, do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. To go to Galilee. There they will see me. After going to Galilee, after Jesus' appearance to his disciples, when he blessed them with peace, what did he say? Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you. Every Sunday is a resurrection day. Every Sunday is the beginning of the week in the biblical calendar. That is the first day of the week. It is not a weekend. We cannot be lazy anymore. We cannot worry about how I'm going to lead my life next week. You cannot withdraw. When you encounter the risen Lord every Sunday, you will be commissioned to go into the world. Every Sunday we gather because to equip ourselves and go back from Monday to Saturday and spread the gospel to people. We are going to nations. Nations are coming to us. Our colleagues, our friends, our co-workers, our visitors. We are going to encounter people. Experiencing Jesus is not just confining ourselves and saying, thank you God for revealing to me. But your duty is that you are commissioned by Christ. You are on a mission in this world. The risen Lord appeared to his disciples and he was commissioning them. Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you. I am sending you. We are the people who have been sent by God. We are the chosen people. We are the holy people called for this royal priesthood. Not to do just the ritualistic things, but to be commissioned. Every Sunday when the worship service, we experience that commissioning. What is the blessing that we say in the last? Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Jesus is love. To have Jesus means to have love. To share the love. You are being commissioned. If you miss one day, you are missing the commissioning of Jesus Christ. Every Sunday, as how Jesus' disciples were gathering. Earlier for the Jewish community, the Sabbath was Saturday. And now because Jesus has risen on the first day of the week, Sunday, the Sunday has made the universal day for the church from the Roman Empire time. The empire which declared that no more propagation of the gospel, the same empire has made way for the construction of the churches. Official holiday for Christmas. Official celebrations of Jesus Christ has begun. The same authority, the same kingdom which obstructed the birth of Jesus Christ. Again, the same persons are used to proclaim the gospel. We are so privileged. Sunday, we do not have jobs. It's a holiday. God has facilitated us to worship Him, to experience that risen Lord and receive that commissioning every Sunday. Sunday worship is not just a ritualistic activity for believers, but it is to experience the risen power and go into the world to seek and serve Him. What did Jesus' disciple do? They received the commission very seriously. They accepted the commission very seriously. After being commissioned, they did not turn back. They did not look back. Before commissioning, they were so timid. They did not have any kind of courage or to speak to the people. They did not go to any school. They did not go to any royal palaces to acquaint themselves with the modern arts or skills of the time. They were ordinary fisher folk, unschooled people. They were commissioned. God wants to use your wisdom. God wants to use your talent. You are very important to God. We cannot decide and say that, no, I am not of use to God. No. Your life is very important to Christ. You are very important. Remember this fact. You are very important. For people, you may not be important. For your family, you may not be important. For Christ, you are important. Jesus Christ has commissioned His disciples. And the same Lord Jesus is commissioning us Sunday, after our gatherings. To chase away our fear, to chase away our weaknesses, to chase away our crying, to chase away our sorrow and weeping. He is coming and appearing to us. He is coming and revealing to us. He is coming and commissioning to us. Are you prepared? Are you prepared to share this wonderful news of Jesus? Are you willing to gather in His name and receive this great commissioning? Are you willing to obey to this commissioning? As the Father has sent me, I am sending you. Because He is a risen Lord. He is the Lord of the living. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, every Sunday is an opportunity to receive the commissioning of Christ. Every gathering is an opportunity to experience the power of Jesus Christ. Every Sunday is a privilege to experience and see the Lord face to face, to touch His feet, to touch His hand, to clear all our doubts and overcome every fear, and to keep moving and await for His coming. Are you prepared? If you are not, this is a day to ask Him. It is a day for you to turn to Christ. This is the day that the Lord has made. You need to rejoice. You need to rejoice and proclaim to the people, yes, He is risen. He is risen indeed. He is risen. He is risen indeed. He is risen. He is risen indeed. Amen.